It's time to step up, prep up.
Step up, prep up.
To help keep you free from the risk of HIV.
From the makers of Truvada, there's another PrEP option, Descovy for PrEP, a once-daily prescription medicine that helps lower the chances of getting HIV through sex. It's not for everyone. Descovy for PrEP has not been studied in people assigned female at birth. Talk to your doctor to find out if it's right for you.
Step up for health and body.
PrEP up for your one and only love, or many loves.
For kings, this queen, and you royals in between.
For my now.
Our now.
And my future.
Our future.
Step up, prep up.
Descovy is another way to prep. Descovy does not prevent other sexually transmitted infections, so it's important to use safer sex practices and get tested regularly.
You must be HIV negative to take Descovy for PrEP, so you need to get tested for HIV immediately before and at least every 3 months while taking it. If you think you were exposed to HIV or have flu-like symptoms, tell your doctor right away. They may check to confirm you are still HIV negative. Serious side effects can occur, including kidney problems and kidney failure. Rare life-threatening side effects include a buildup of lactic acid and liver problems. The most common side effect was diarrhea. Tell your doctor about all the medicines and supplements you take, or if you have kidney or liver problems, including hepatitis. If you have hepatitis B, do not stop taking Descovy without talking to your doctor. Ask your doctor about your risk of HIV, and if Descovy for PrEP is right for you.
Words are loud, but actions are louder.
Step up.
Prep up.
With Descovy for PrEP.
Get help paying for Descovy for PrEP. Learn more at stepupprepup.com.
Welcome. Hello, AIDS Awareness family. Welcome to the All Boys Aren't Blue, a memoir manifesto pre-party. The next 2 hours promise to be engaging, informative, and filled with special live performances. My name is Miguel McInnis. I'm CEO of the Metro Health. We are a proud sponsor of today's live event. As we come together virtually to celebrate National Black HIV Awareness Day, know that Metro Health, a community health center in Washington, D.C., has been leading this effort for over 30 years. When each of our Black and Brown brothers and sisters receive the needed HIV, primary care, and essential mental and substance abuse services, our communities will then have a real fighting chance to rid health disparities that are disproportionately impacting our communities. When this happens, communities nationally will begin to experience what our patients in the D.C. area know as the Metro Health Experience. This involves access to quality primary care and behavioral health services, as well as essential services that support the whole person. So, welcome to the party. Please allow me to introduce Metro Health's ambassador, Rodney Chester. Rodney, take us away.
What's the tea?
Hello. We are here at the pre-show for All Boys Aren't Blue. Okay. I am Rodney Chester from Noah's Ark. Y'all know me, honey. Y'all better get it together. I see y'all in this chat room. Come on in and chat and get ready. We are at the pre-show. I'm so excited to be here. And hey, that just now was the CEO, Miguel, of Metro Health DC. Now, come here. Closer. Y'all see my mug? Now, that was the CEO of Metro Health DC. The CEO. So that means what he said, I am the ambassador for 2021.
Is there some tea?
And I'm ecstatic to be a part of it, okay? So you guys make sure y'all go on and look up Metro Health DC, okay? Thank you again, Miguel. I so appreciate you. Hey, so listen. Also, I have an amazing DJ. DJ Poison Ivy. Okay? Give it up for her. She is going to be playing the tunes, giving us all this kind of great music, and she's going to be letting us see what is popping. If you guys got a request maybe or something, maybe she'll play it. Who knows? We'll see. But you all get in that chat room, and let's see what's going on, because we want to thank her for being a part of All Boys Aren't Blue. Okay, this is where we are. You gotta be here. Be here. Okay.
Is there some tea?
Okay, let's see. What else is on the docket? Okay. We're gonna go now to New York City to the boys at Lambda Lounge. Charles and Richard, take it away. Pre-show.
So Lambda Lounge was created
Because we saw a need for a safe space for queer people of color in our community, which was sorely lacking. Those days of us having spaces like this are long gone, and we wanted to bring it back. Harlem is the epicenter of Black culture. Where better to open an establishment owned by two Black men? More importantly, two Black gay men. It's a good home. The reason why we decided to make this space for LGBTQ, we were at an establishment here in Harlem, actually, not too far from this very space. We were hanging out with a couple of friends. It was a straight establishment. And the DJ stopped the entire party and said, men don't dance with men here. You know, yelled it out over the entire crowd. And that kind of struck a nerve. It reminded me that though we are present, we are only being tolerated. And this space here, the Lambda Lounge here, we're not tolerated here. We are accepted here six days a week. 6 days a week, not seven. I need my rest. But 6 days a week, we're accepted here. This is our space, this is our home. This is where people can come and be themselves and not be concerned about the toleration and when that toleration is done.
And we hope that people outside of the LGBTQ plus community will accept us as well in the community, because we had a chance to meet a lot of the neighbors and they've been very open, you know, with, you know, welcoming us to the neighborhood as well as giving us useful advice on business, like, you know, who to work with and what to do. So we really appreciate that as well.
Yeah, you'd be surprised how accepting people are. We thought it was going to be a little harder, but it's been good.
Yeah.
All right. I'm Richard Solomon.
And I'm Charles Hughes. And we are proud Harlem business owners.
Hey, no. Welcome, everybody. We at the Lambda Lounge here in Harlem, New York, live, rocking with DJ Boy. And she's killing on the ones and twos. We want y'all to come in, party with us for the next 45 minutes to an hour.
On the floor, we all be going down.
Okay, so hey, we are here at the pre-show, for All Boys Aren't Blue. You guys make sure you look it up and support us in this amazing campaign, okay? Listen, so I am getting ready to do this show, which is called Sweet Tea Sundays. And basically, it's my show. We're doing it virtual now, but it's going to be some of my special guests, and it's going to be people that have talent. I do drag. We do comedians. We do singers. We do spoken word artists. So it's a variety show. And I want you guys to be a part of it. So if you want me to come to your city, you guys better call Richard Pelzer. It's real simple. And all his info will be down in this chat. So y'all can call him immediately if you want me to bring Sweet Tea Sundays to a city near you. But we're just doing it virtual now. But I have some special guests that have joined me today for the pre-show that's within my Sweet Tea. They're Rodney and Friends. So you guys, I have Jacob Lusk from American Idol. I have Blairisms, which is an organization. They are amazing at what they do. They do a Savage Chat. I have been on the Savage Chat. So many of us, they have a lot of celebrities that have been on there. I have also Dr. Jazmyne Simmons. Dr. Jazmyne Simmons, okay? Amazing. I can't wait to talk to her. And then I have the one and only, do you really want to touch it? I'll pop it right here, sitting right here. Monifah will be in the house, okay? So I want you guys to go on the chat, talk to us. We're gonna be doing this live. It's the pre-show. Our show starts at 8 o'clock. This is all coming out, so you guys make sure you support and come in and see what's going on, okay? The chat down there, you chat and let me know what's going on. Tell me something.
Hi, my name is Rodney Chester. You may know me as Alex from Noah's Ark. With COVID-19 and all the health disparities that disproportionately impact our community, I've decided to get more involved in advocating for our rights to great health. I am proud to be a Metro Health Ambassador. Metro Health is a community health center in Washington, D.C. They provide primary care and HIV services, including PrEP and also mental health and substance abuse. They are fantastic at helping people manage chronic diseases such as diabetes, HIV, and cardiovascular disease. They also have a wonderful outreach team who help you get linked to other essential services that help us stay healthy, such as housing, food, and medical insurance. Please call Metro Health today to find out how they can help you and your family at 202-638-0750 or book your appointment at metrohealthdc.org. If you're not in the DMV area, no problem. You can find a community health center near you by going to findahealthcenter.hrsa.gov. You deserve to have a Metro Health day.
Hey. Y'all look cute.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, hey. Oh, hey. Here is my guys, Blairisms. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Rodney. Okay, now, so good first of all, wait, let me say this. How does it feel being on the other side? You guys are always doing what I'm doing. I said we're doing this pre-show for All Boys Aren't Blue. This campaign is amazing. And I had to get you guys involved because, first of all, I love you guys. I love what you do. I love your work. But what really made me just something clicked in me is I was just, you know, looking at your page, stalking your page, of course.
I see
somebody singing, and I say, "Wait a minute, hold up." And I looked again. I said, I didn't know you could sing like that. I had no idea.
Thank you.
I appreciate that.
I really didn't. So this whole thing is a part of my what I'm doing. I'm the ambassador for Metro Health out of Washington, D.C. But I'm working on this Sweet Tea thing again so that we can hopefully get it back out there. And I have singers and performers and comedians and drag performers. And when I saw you, I was like, oh, no, he got to be a part of this campaign show. He got to be this pre-show. Yeah. You have to be a part of it. But before we get to that, I just kind of want to know, you know, you guys were such a big, big part of Noah's Ark, the reunion, the virtual reunion, which we won a GLAAD award.
Congratulations.
We're excited about that. Woo! But yeah, you guys were such a big part of that. And that's kind of how we met and all. And so it's appreciated that you guys do that. But now tell them a little bit about you guys and about your site. You have merchandise and all that. Let's get that out.
So we started the Blairisms about 4 years ago. We are brand activists. So we use the platform and we use the apparel line to raise awareness for Black culture and celebrate Black people and Black culture. And it is an extraordinary experience. And we started the Savage Collection, which we're so honored to include Noah's Ark as a part of that and be a part of the reunion. And
we now also started the Savage Chat series that you alluded to that we've been on now for our second season for about a week now. And we're honored to have had so many of the folks who are
amazing
tonight's event a part of the Savage Chat series. George, Nathan, Tommy Thompson,
so it's a party,
it's
y'all.
A party.
So check it out on Instagram.
Yes.
You can get the Savage Collection at theblairisms.com.
Okay, great. So I want you guys, all that's going to be in the chat because I know, where are you guys from?
New Orleans all day.
New Orleans. Okay, well, we got to get, if they're in the chat here, you guys, let's give it up for New Orleans. Come on. I know that they're in the chat. Yeah. So we definitely, I definitely got to have you amazing. But I want to thank you guys again so much for being a part of this. And can you give, all Boys Aren't Blue a shout out?
Listen, shout out to George Johnson.
George Johnson is an incredible,
amazing.
I mean, we cannot wait to see what comes of this and his new project.
And this is the thing about this is a memoir for the for posterity.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
This is something that is going to change the lives of people who are walking the planet now and generations and generations and generations from now. Mm-hmm. And so we are honored to know George, to be a part of this and to see what the future will bring for all that they have in store for all of us.
And we got to give a shout out to Nathan Hale
Williams,
who is Uncle
amazing.
Pelzer,
Nathan,
all of the folks, I mean, just such extraordinary Blackcellence. We call it Blackcellence over at Blairisms. And the extraordinary levels of not only Blackcellence, but queer Blackcellence is being exhibited with all of the displays of creativity and art. It's extraordinary, and we are grateful to be a part of this time in history with all of these incredible
people. What a joy
people.
It is to be
exactly. And I think what you guys are doing are amazing. You know, I love you. We're going to be working together on some things, so I'm excited about that. So you guys, make sure you look them up. Everything is going to be posted down here. This pre-show is live. We're going to be ready for All Boys Aren't Blue. Give it up for my brothers, Blairisms. Give it up for them. Thank you guys so much again. Thank you.
Hi, I'm DJ Poison Ivy, and I'm honored to join this powerful campaign to say, stigma gotta go. We are all in this together, and truly believe community is our superpower.
What's going on, people? My name is Charles Hughes.
And I'm Richard Solomon, and we are the owner and operators of the Lambda Lounge here in Harlem, New York.
We are honored to join this powerful campaign to say, stigma gotta go. We are in this together, and we truly believe community is our superpower.
What's up, fam? My name is Claxton. I'm a bartender here at Lambda Lounge in Harlem, and I'm going to teach you how to make Love of Lambda one of our signature drinks. So to start, I'm going to fill your glass up with ice. And then we're going to do 2 ounces of Lambda Vodka. And then 1 ounce each of elderflower liqueur. pomegranate, of course. Then finish with orange juice. Leave a little bit at the top for seltzer. And then roll it to mix it all together. Top with some soda water. Our garnish. Three little cherries. Some mint. Smack it to activate it. And there you go. Lovely. Thank you to iN-Hale Entertainment, George Johnson, and remember, community is our superpower.
Hi, everybody. Okay, so I'm back. We are here at the pre-show for All Boys Aren't Blue. You guys make sure that you look it up and be ready for our show at 8 p.m. Okay, make sure you be ready at 8 p.m. New York time, 5 o'clock L.A. Okay, you guys figure it out. 8 o'clock in New York, 5 in L.A. You okay, great. But I want to throw a special shout out to Rodney Love Jones. He is an art collector, amazing guy, amazing personality, actually. And he is just an amazing guy. You can go and check out his website at bylovejones.com, bylovejones.com. Go and check him out, okay?
Hello, everyone. My name is Rodney Love Jones, and I am the curator for the All Boys Aren't Blue Dramatic Reading. And we welcome you here tonight to just love this presentation. It is just unbelievably wonderful. I was brought in to use the imagery that Charlie Palmer, the American artist Charlie Palmer, his genius cover, I needed to bring it to life. So Nathan Hale Williams, the director, called me and said, I need you to give me color, emotion, and I need black boy joy, but I need some sadness to catapult that joy. The script is written in a way of full emotion and full wonderment. There is a vignette where George talks about his grandmother, and that is so well done. There's a piece in the installation of one of the artists, his name is Jamal, Jamal's grandmother Peachy, and it's set really beautifully in the background. I love the fact that this script talks about the ingenuity and the brilliance of love and forgiveness and understanding. I didn't know which direction I was going to go in until Nathan said, what I want you to do is find new voices, different narratives, but I need it to be full of black boy emotion. And that's what I did. So we have artists from New York, we have artists from LA, Chicago, Milwaukee, DC, Atlanta, and it's gonna be really, really beautiful. So sit back, relax, watch the presentation, let me know how much you loved it, and go to www.bylovejones.com to shop our virtual gallery installation. The name of the project is called Exploration Blue, and it is featuring several artists with several different narratives, and you can be a first-time collector of original art. Thank you so much. Enjoy.
Hi, my name is Rodney Chester. You may know me as Alex from Noah's Ark. With COVID-19 and all the health disparities that disproportionately impact our community, I've decided to get more involved in advocating for our rights to great health. I am so proud to be a Metro Health Ambassador. Metro Health is a community health center in Washington, D.C. Did you know that one out of two black gay men are HIV positive in our country? Also, we are 40% behind white gay men for taking PrEP, which can literally stop the transmission of HIV.
So please learn more about PrEP to prevent the spread of HIV and get you some care. HIV is a manageable chronic disease. Please call my folks at Metro Health so they can help you out. They can help you and your family at 202-638-0750 or book an appointment at metrohealth.org. If you're not in the DMV, no problem. You can find a community health center near you by going to inthehealthcenter.hrsa.gov/. You deserve to have a Metro Health Day.
Also, I want to give another special shout out to LD Morrow. LD Morrow.
Thank you, Rodney. And may I say, you look amazing as you always do. Look at you. Anyway, hello everyone. I am LD Morrow, author of the award-winning book, Think Like a Bartender, Recipes for Life. And when I tell you, I am absolutely excited to be here today. I'm happy to celebrate the All Boys Aren't Blue virtual pre-party. And when you think about it, it is a party, right? We have an amazing DJ. We have dope music. We have outstanding talent. I think something's missing, right? If I'm at a party, I got the DJ, I got the music, I got the talent. I know what's missing. A drink. And that's why I'm here today. So, for the All Boys Aren't Blue virtual pre-party signature drink, I will be making for you today what I call the reflection. I hope you guys can like edit and have like diamonds. Probably not, right? Okay, but the reflection. The reason I call this drink the reflection is it's a cocktail for any time of the day. It's light, it's refreshing, but be careful. It is stronger than you think. And that's what I want all of you to think about when you look in the mirror at your reflection, that you are also stronger than you think. Okay, let's get to making this cocktail, right? So what we're gonna need here are four simple ingredients. First, you're gonna need some gin. I will be using Hendrick's gin. Let me get that up there. I love Hendrick's because it's an amazing taste and it gives notes of roses and cucumbers and all these botanicals. It's a sexy kind of gin. Next, we're gonna be using Saint Germain. Saint Germain is an elderflower liqueur. Now, if you wonder what an elderflower liqueur is, they said that this has 1,000 flowers inside the bottle. That alone is amazing to me. But it gives a sweet taste without really being too sugary. You know, and that's one of the things I love about Saint Germain. The third ingredient is lemon juice, and we're simply gonna use a good old lemon. And finally, what cocktail wouldn't be great with a little Prosecco or champagne? Not both, Nathan. Just choose one. So I will be using La Marca. That's a really nice Prosecco. I have a small bottle here because I don't want to waste it. And that's it. So what do you say we make this thing? All right, we're ready? First, you're going to start with 1.5 ounces of Hendrick's. Now, as I'm pouring this Hendrick's, one thing I want to remind you of is I don't have ice in my cup already because I don't want the ice to kind of pre-dilute the liquor. All right, so we got 1.5 ounces of Hendrick's. Then we're gonna do 1 ounce of the Saint Germain. All right, pour that in there. And finally, you need about 3/4 of an ounce of lemon juice. So I'm gonna use fresh squeezed lemon already prepped here. And I'm gonna kind of do it by sight because I know what's about three, almost within my eye of lemon juice. That's it. All right, so we have our lemon juice in it. Now, I'm gonna add the ice. So, here we go. Add a few cubes of ice, and then we shake. Now I wanna shake this for about 20 to 30 seconds, but you're not gonna stand there and watch me shake for 20 to 30 seconds. So I'm gonna shake lightly, and I think I'm gonna tell you about my favorite chapter in the book, Think Like a Bartender. My favorite chapter is called What Are You Serving? And this chapter really talks about presenting your authentic self. So if someone were to walk into your restaurant of your personality and read your menu, and your menu said that you have kindness, patience, love, understanding, if they ordered that, would you be out of stock? Would you be misrepresenting yourself? You see, we all stand at the bars of our lives and have to serve others. The least you can do is serve up your best self. All right, that sounded like it was about 20 seconds, right? All right, we'll take the top off. I already have a strainer here.
I have a beautiful glass I'm gonna use. And let's pour this. I can't tell you what it smells like because it smells amazing right now. All the elderflower and those botanicals smells amazing. Okay, now I know what you're thinking. Lo, you gonna leave me hanging like this? Absolutely not. Now, we top it off with the Prosecco or champagne. This is an amazingly light, refreshing drink. Like I said, you can have it any day or night. It's missing something. You know what? Let's take a lemon peel, beautiful lemon peel. And actually, old school trick I like to do, you can just take it around the rim of the glass, twist it and drop it in, and I present the reflection. I'm gonna sip, just watch me, it's okay. That's really good. And you know on shows, people say it's really good, and you think they're faking. This is really good, really strong, and really smooth. So cheers, everyone. Thank you for inviting me. And I want to give a shout out to Nathan and the entire production team. We are so proud of you, and we are ready, drinking, and watching. Oh, and remember, guys, stigma gotta go. Let's continue to work together as a community to rid it of the HIV and AIDS stigma. After all, I mean, community is our superpower, right? So thank you, guys. Cheers. And back to you, Rodney, with your well-dressed self. Cheers, guys.
Hi! Okay, you guys, listen. We are back at the pre-show for All Boys Aren't Blue. You guys, listen. Let me just break this down real simple, okay? My next guest, special guest, okay, is, first of all, she's my friend, but I have loved her amazingly as a fan of her work and her music and who she is, and then getting to know her over the years, it's just been a blessing and just so amazing. And when I asked her to do this, she was like, of course, no problem. And you guys need to look out for it also, because we're going to be working together. Anyway, we'll talk about that later. But I want to introduce you guys to my girl. She's amazing at what she do. Give it up for Monifah.
Yay. Hi, Rodney. I love you.
Do you really wanna
me tonight? Oh.
Hey, you know what? I was just looking at some behind the scenes or something, and they had Heavy D. Mm-hmm. What you guys don't know, Mo, if I'm not mistaken, Heavy D was your protege, right?
Like, he was I was his protege.
I mean, your mentor. I mean, you was his protege, yeah. Right? Right. And so,
Uptown Records. Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, this is what we have here, guys.
Yeah.
Like, this is what we have here. But you know, alongside that, you know, Mo was on an amazing show, reality show. She got married on. I think you were the first female.
Same female. To have their nuptials televised, their whole wedding. I mean, you know,
And it was amazing. So give a shout out to Therese. Hey, boo.
Yeah, we also won a Glad Award.
Yeah,
we won.
So hey, just excited to be that. So I just wanted to find out, babe. Like, what are you, what are you working on now? I know you had some videos. You was doing different things. I know you got so much fire going, and you just, you know. Everybody want a piece of Monifah.
Oh Lord.
What are you are you working on anything or gearing towards something?
Absolutely. First of all, me. Always me first, working on the inner, the emotional, the mental. I'm in a great place. That maintains first, so I could do everything else. But right. I've produced a short film called Girl Talk. We're writing our own vehicle, my wife and Therese and I, and working on my new musical projects and my theatrical project, which is semi-autobiographical.
Yeah.
And, just focusing on, being able to reach my audience, myself,
right.
You know what I mean? Because I can do whatever I want. I could be in as many lanes as I'd like to be. I can do all the things that I find myself interested in doing. I also crochet. I'm just super creative. I do a lot. I do a lot with my hands. I made my bathroom vanity and the house. Like, I do a lot of stuff, you know. But as far as my career, those things I'm, you know, producing and directing are on my plate for sure.
Well, but I, you know, I also, like I told you, we talked personally and I said, you are an amazing actress too. Like, you did plays. Like, I don't think people know that you did the whole play circuit as well.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I did Men Cry in the Dark, which was Michael Basin's book that Jakari is my first. That's my first. That was my first endeavor with Jakarius Johnson. Did his first play, which was Men Cry in the Dark, the adaptation, the stage adaptation of Michael Basin's book. I read that book and I loved it. But when I first got my manager at the time, he was like, Mo, you want to do a stage play? And immediately my elitist, because I come from off-Broadway theater in New York. I started at 7 years old. You know, I've been doing it for a long time. And so I was a little elitist. And I was like, I'm not doing that old mother Lord Jesus and I can't.
No, ma'am. No.
And I was just like, no, I'm okay, thanks. I was really like very that. And he was like, you sure you don't want to do it? And I was like, no. He called back. He was like, your book. And I hadn't even asked him what it was. And then he told me. And I was like, oh my God, I love that book. And incidentally, my favorite character is who they wanted me to play, which was Tracy the lawyer. So I said, yeah.
That was meant to be.
I was in great company. I was in, you know, in cast with Richard Roundtree, Rona Bennett. She's from Vogue now. She was a Disney kid and she was on Jamie Foxx show, and Alan Payne and Christopher Williams, who are both long time friends of mine. So I was
Hold up. You just said a name and I had to
Christopher Williams.
Don't do that.
Ooh.
I love me some Christopher Williams. Anyway, go ahead on. But listen, baby, we all support you. Definitely, you guys, you're in the chat down there. I know you guys are loving Mo like I love her. So you have questions down there, put it in. She's going to put down some things that she's working on and whatever so you guys can see it. Hit her up on her social media. Mo, listen, thank you again for taking the time out of your busy schedule and come and chat with your brother. I appreciate you. I love you. You guys stay tuned for some things that me and Mo are going to be working on together. I told her I'm coming to get her. So listen, all boys aren't blue. You guys, thank you so much for supporting us. And we are here back. We are here at the pre-show. We will see you guys at 8 o'clock. Okay, thanks, Mo. I love you.
Love you too. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Always a good vibe and good feeling. Good vibe, good feeling. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Oh, yeah. Big shout out to Nathan H. Lewis, of course. How you doing?
hope everybody's enjoying themselves and having a good time. Special thanks to Nathan Hale Williams and iN-Hale Entertainments for allowing Metro Health DC to sponsor the All Boys Aren't Blue, a memoir, manifesto pre-party. As Metro Health's prep clinic manager, Charles Brown, I have the privilege to assist patients with their essential healthcare needs and support service referrals. It's humbling to know that I'm a member of a team of dedicated professionals who are committed to healthcare excellence. Let's continue celebrating our AIDS awareness and prevention milestone accomplishments while remembering with extra effort, we can win the fight against AIDS. Enjoy.
Hi, we're back. Welcome to the pre-show. Listen, you guys, thanks again so much for supporting All Boys Aren't Blue. We are getting ready for a huge premiere at 8 o'clock. You guys, make sure you tune in, text a friend, let them know what we're doing and what's happening so they can all be a part of it. But I want to bring in another special guest of mine. She is so amazing. Can we bring in, please, Dr. Jazmyne Simmons? Hi, Jazmyne. How are you? Wait a minute. Jazmyne.
Yes.
Girl, you a doctor?
Yes.
Girl, you look like, honey, you look like you by, girl. Okay, well, hey, this is Dr. Jazmyne Sullivan. I just had to give a double take because she gives me very, very young girl, 18. I don't know, you know, what's going on. But listen, thank you, Jazz, so much for being a part of this. We just thought that you were such amazing person at what you do and the guide that you have that can lead us into a lot of information. So can you give us some statistics and let us know some things what we possibly can do and what we can help us through this pandemic and what you think, what's your take on it?
Absolutely, Rodney. Thank you for flattering and having me.
Of course.
Sure thing. So just to go into it a little bit, we have heard since the onset of the epidemic, right, that African Americans are, you know, at high risk and disproportionately impacted. The LGBTQ plus community is disproportionately impacted. And unfortunately, those numbers have not changed. So from the most recent data from CDC, African Americans account for 42% of the new HIV diagnoses annually, right? And to put that into perspective, African Americans or Blacks, as CDC reports it, only account for about 13% of the US population. So while only accounting for 13%, we make up 42% of the new HIV AIDS diagnoses. And then when we break that down a little bit further, it's male-to-male sexual contact that continues to be at higher rates among African-Americans, as well as women and heterosexual activity among women. And so when we think about why are our numbers consistently increasing while other ethnicities and races may be seeing a decline, one of those things that we consistently see in our community is stigma. And stigma manifests in several different ways. And so we can have community stigma, such as, you know, feeling some kind of way about HIV or those who are living with HIV or those who are high risk for HIV. And then we have things like internalized stigma, where individuals who may be already living with HIV have internalized those negative feelings about themselves because of what others have portrayed towards them. And so these particular experiences continue to manifest within our community and perpetuate the HIV epidemic. Why? Because if someone feels negatively about themselves, they may be less likely to engage in care, less likely to adhere to their medical regimen. They may also be less likely to even get tested to know their status. And so when we speak about ending the HIV epidemic, we have to talk about ending the stigma. And ending the stigma can happen in many ways. Over time, we've heard messaging consistently about HIV prevention, HIV care, and sometimes that can present some type of fatigue, consistently hearing these messages. But the power that film brings, the power of the work such as All Boys Aren't Blue and the 90 Days film, the power of showing African Americans or Blacks on screen living their own realities and having these stories told by African Americans or Blacks, those who are living this reality, allows us to be absorbed into a narrative in a way that our cognitive and emotional aspects are influenced, right? And so these things allow us to engage in a way that we normally probably wouldn't engage with, say, for an infographic or a brochure. And it allows us to really immerse ourselves in a different perspective or see our own perspectives played out. And so that is very important when we're talking about using film to address stigma, using film to address HIV, because there's a fine line between being stereotypical and showing the reality. And when you have us telling our own narratives, we walk that line of reality. We engage ourselves cognitively and emotionally. We can learn through this virtual or vicarious experience. And then we can feel self-efficacious or feel confident that we can go out and make a difference in our community, in our personal lives, as it relates to ending the stigma and subsequently ending the HIV epidemic. We can do this.
Wow. I tell you, I am the ambassador for Metro Health of DC. And we've got to have you at some point come on, whether if it's virtue or something in DC, because your numbers and what you talked about is so amazing and it's so needed that we can have an understanding. I played the HIV and AIDS counselor in Noah's Ark. And I mean, I learned so much just from doing that, so much that I didn't know. So your statistics and things that you say is so important. And I definitely want to bring you on with something that we're doing with Metro Health of DC, because your numbers are amazing. But I want to thank you so much. Greatly appreciate you coming on. We are here at the pre-show. Dr. Yes. Jazmyne Sullivan is in the house. We appreciate all her knowledge and everything she brought to this. And you guys, it would also be great, Jazz. We're going to have people in, there are people in the chat, everybody want to, so if you want to drop a line in or drop down some of the statistics would be great, just so that people can have it in their mindset. Okay. Absolutely. Thanks again so much.
I would love to. Thank you so much for having me. I would love to join you in future engagements. I'm a huge fan, and my sister Ebony is as well. Love you.
Where is Ebony at?
She's in the other room. I don't know if she wants to come on camera because she's not all dolled up. But
you know what? Tell Ebony to come here right quick.
Rodney said, come here.
I want to say hi to her. Goodness.
We love you and Noah's Ark. And
no, thank you.
The role of playing the HIV counselor, I mean, seeing these things play out on screen just has a whole different effect when we're talking about
Asian. It really does. It really does. And even being a part of, like you said, 90 Days with Nathan, who's an amazing writer and director. Absolutely. It was so amazing to be a part of that because Nathan, he really knows how to tell amazing stories. You know what I mean? I give that all to him because we're friends, but I also appreciate him for what he do. And I tell him all the time, I say, I just appreciate you. So it's great. And like you said, when it's live and on TV, it changes.
It does.
It does. It really does.
It forces people to engage in a way that, if I'm watching a commercial or someone hands me a brochure, I can toss that. But when you start messing with my emotions and get me all involved in characters like Jessica, I can't turn, right? I can't turn my head from that. So, that is the power. Come on, Ebony. Rodney said, come on.
Ebony, come on, girl. We got to get out of here.
Hey!
Hey, boo. How are you doing? Well, you know what? All fans are good fans. I appreciate it. That's why I told her, tell Ebony to come here so I can meet her. Nice to meet you so much.
Nice to meet you too.
Your sister is lovely. She's amazing.
I know.
She's amazing.
Thank you.
She's amazing. So thank you. So you guys, we are here again. Like I said, we're at the pre-show. All Boys Aren't Blue. You guys make sure you tune in at 8 o'clock so you can see the show. And I just want to thank you. And thank you again, Jazmyne. I really appreciate you being here.
Thank you.
Okay. We'll keep in touch. Hit me up on social media.
I sure will.
It's Rodney, ITS Rodney _ Instagram.
Look, I'm already following you. So
you already following me?
Boom.
Girl, you better send me a message.
I will.
Okay, baby. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Thank you. Thank you.
Rodney and Jazmyne, thank you for that amazing insight. This is Dr. Mowatt, Vice President of Education at One Pulse Foundation, and we are proud of partnering with the dramatic reading of All Boys Aren't Blue as it fits perfectly with our core values. One Pulse Foundation's purpose is to create change, build love, and to open hearts, minds, eyes, and doors through our priorities. Our priorities include building the National Pulse Memorial and Museum, our educational programming, and our 49 legacy scholarships. We aim to impact social change at the individual, group, and community levels through our efforts. We focus on how we are actually more alike than we are different. We're launching One Pulse Academy, which is the education arm of the foundation, on February 17th at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, with the first of our conversations, start of film series, and panel discussion. And I am happy to announce that we are launching it with the short film, 90 Days. 90 Days was written and directed by Nathan Hale Williams and co-directed by Jania Frederic Aponte. 90 Days is a riveting story of love, integrity, and compassion that explores a beautiful couple's relationship and their altering decision after 90 days of dating. We're happy to be partnering with the entire 90 Days team to present this virtual screening of the film on February 17th from 7 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time. One Pulse Academy's Conversation Starter Series is designed to spark conversations on acceptance and inclusion, compassion, and our shared humanity. Let's get the conversation started. So mark your calendar for Wednesday, February 17th at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. We welcome you to this free virtual screening of 90 Days and panel discussion. And also, make sure to tell a friend. We hope to see you all there. For more information, please visit our website, onepulsefoundation.org. And I'm certainly looking forward to seeing you at the screening. See you then, and thanks.
Hi. How are you guys doing? We're back. Listen, I want to bring on my special guest. His name is Jacob Lusk. Come on in, Jacob. Hi, Jacob. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
Good. Thank you so much for coming on and being my special guest. I just want you to know that we appreciate you so much and your talent. I first saw you on American Idol, which you were fantastic, amazing. And I have been keeping following you and knowing that you have some new stuff. You're going a different direction now. So what are you working on now?
Yes, I am now a member of a trio called Gabriels, and we put out some new kind of, I don't want, experimental music, I guess you could say. It's a mix between Nina Simone, Nat King Cole, with a little bit of Prince on it.
Oh, wow. That sounds good. So what made you go that direction from R&B?
When I did Idol, there were a lot of comparisons to like Luther, which I love, but I found myself creating music just like that. Like, oh, that's what the people want to hear, so let me do that. That's what I think the people want to hear, so let me write that. And I found myself in a box, and so I said, well, let's get rid of that. I got in the studio with some of my friends, and we just literally just wrote songs that we love. We weren't trying to sound like anything. We just like, we're just going to make great music, and Gabriel's worked.
Well, hey, I have heard some of the music, and it is amazing now. I cannot let you be on here without singing a little something, whatever you want. Just give me a little bit.
Okay. Someday, when I'm awfully low and the world is cold, I will get a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight.
Wow. Okay. You know what? I was just listening to that. That was giving me a little Billie Holiday for some reason. That's kind of what I was like, wait a minute. Because I love Billie Holiday. But listen, that sounds amazing. So I know you're on Spotify. You're on a lot of different things. Can you give us that? We're going to put that in the bottom chat, you guys. We're here at this pre-show. You guys check Jacob out. Where can we find you?
I'm on Instagram, Facebook, everything at I Am Jacob Lusk. The name of my group is Gabriels. Our album is called Love and Hate in a Different Time. And the latest single is a song called The Blind. There's a video for it.
Okay.
take it.
Okay, well, I think we're gonna show a little piece of that. But listen, I just want to thank you again so much, and also you guys are on Spotify, Amazon,
Apple Music, everywhere.
Okay, so you guys, hey. You guys got to go and support the brother because, hey, he is doing his own thing. And it's amazing because now we have to create our own and do what we do best. Thank you so much, Jacob. We appreciate you for coming on. All Boys Aren't Blue is airing. The premiere is at 8 p.m. So can you give them a shout out? Can you
give them a shout out? Congratulations on making this amazing film, All Boys Aren't Blue. I can't wait to watch it tonight. I'm excited.
Okay. Thank you so much, and we'll see you later. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
When you're close to me, and it's hard to breathe when you feel inside. When you're close to me, it ain't supposed to be the place I'd rather have. We had everything till you did that thing. Now blue skies are gone. Let your feelings show. How can you sleep at night? Tears come out of night.
Okay, wow. Okay, so now listen, guys. We are at this pre-show. I am so excited. All Boys Aren't Blue. So excited. The premiere is at 8 o'clock, which is coming right up. I just want to give a couple of more shout-outs. Well, first of all, let me go back to one of my other special guests. I kept saying Jazmyne Sullivan. Listen, you guys, I was just listening to Jazmyne Sullivan, and I was in my moment. I was in my beat, and then I was talking to Dr. Jazmyne Simmons. Jazmyne Simmons. So I just want to clear that up because I was all over the place. But anyway, love her. But thank you again, Jacob. So you guys, we are here for this premiere down here in the chat. You guys, make sure you send us messages. You can look me up at @itsrodney_. That's my Instagram. You can follow me on Facebook, Rodney Chester. I have a lot of things coming up. I am the ambassador for Metro Health of DC. You guys keep an eye out for that. We're going to have a lot of special events happening and all that's going on. I want to give some shout outs to the man of the hour, George M. Johnson. Thank you. I have to give another special shout out to Nathan Hale Williams for your amazing vision and what you do. We love you. And also the producer, who is my friend. He's my manager. You can always hit him up about me, whatever you need. But anyway, he set all this up and put everything in motion. He's a producer. His name is Richard Pelzer. Please look him up. Look up Nathan. Nathan is on Instagram as well. Nathan Hale Williams. I just want to thank you guys so much for tuning in. We are so excited for this premiere. And you guys, listen, y'all need to text. Y'all need to go in the street, yell, get on the megaphone. Whatever you got to do, do live. Actually, you know what? You guys are here. Go live on Facebook. Go live on Facebook. So we can really get this going. Okay? All Boys Aren't Blue. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. We'll see you at 8. Bye-bye.
Hi, my name is Rodney Chester. You may know me as Alex from Noah's Ark. With COVID-19 and all the health disparities that disproportionately impact our community, I've decided to get more involved in advocating for our rights to great health. I'm proud to be a Metro Health Ambassador. Metro Health is a community health center in Washington, D.C. You all know that COVID-19 has held the world on lockdown for a year. The good news is vaccines are working. Get vaccinated today. Call Metro Health to find out when you can get your vaccine to protect you and your family at 202-638-0750. If you're not in the DMV, no problem. You can find a community health center near you by going to findahealthcenter.hrsa.gov. Last thing, please wear a mask and go to the CDC for accurate info on the vaccine. Metro Health has some great resources on their website about COVID-19 vaccine. You deserve to be healthy and strong. Wear a mask.